Hello everyone and welcome back to the world of finance. You are watching Finance Concepts with Nikhil. My friends, in this session we are going to talk about portfolio composition. So one of the very important concepts in portfolio theory, that is portfolio composition. So let me first give you a brief of what exactly we mean by portfolio composition. So the first stage in portfolio composition would be to construct a portfolio, then to actively manage the portfolio. So constructing a portfolio would encompass certain steps. First thing, you identify various stocks that you would want to include in the portfolio in the first order, and then once you identify which stocks you would want to include in your portfolio, second step would be to identify how much of your money you are going to allocate among each of these stocks. So it will be selection of stocks and allocation of your funds or your money over these stocks to construct a portfolio. However, once the portfolio has been constructed, no matter how efficiently you construct a portfolio, but whether that constructed portfolio will remain efficient throughout, there is no guarantee. Therefore, you as a portfolio manager have to constantly look into whether the portfolio is performing efficiently or not. At this stage, you would want to identify whether the portfolio's efficiency is maintained or not. For that, you constantly evaluate your portfolio's performance. And to do that, there are various techniques, okay? One simplest way would be Jensen's alpha. Basically, you try to determine alpha of your portfolio and you just look into whether that alpha is positive or not. If the alpha of your portfolio is positive, that means your portfolio is performing fine. Now assume that you have included four stocks A, B, C, D in your portfolio initially. And that time you have constructed an efficient portfolio. At that stage, I would say you have made some allocation among these four stocks A, B, C, D. Later on, when you identify whether your portfolio is still performing efficiently or not, the straight simple way would be to use Jensen's alpha. That is, you determine alpha of your portfolio. My friends, I'm sure in the earlier class when we have talked about portfolio alpha, you know what is portfolio alpha, correct? So you would determine portfolio alpha and look into whether that is positive or not. By chance you find portfolio alpha going negative, means your portfolio is underperforming. Your portfolio is not performing efficiently. Then you would want to look into all four stocks A, B, C, D, and again, the best way would be to identify Jensen's alpha for each individual stock. Maybe two of the stocks are giving positive alpha and other two are giving negative alpha. Then you would want to change the composition of your portfolio from negative alpha stocks. You would want to drag some money and put it more of that money in positive alpha. So friends, there will be different situations, and I told you at later stage we are going to understand that there are even other parameters to evaluate the performance of portfolio. But let us first focus on this approach, what we have just talked about, that is Jensen's alpha. However, in later classes, we will also look into how would you allocate your money among various stocks that you have identified. That is what we call as optimum allocation or optimum weight portfolio. How to determine those optimum weights is not covered in this session, that will come up in later sessions. So let us first deal with an example that can explain you this whole concept of portfolio composition. Let us take up question number 44. Let us read this question. What is given over here? Mr. V has rupees 5 lakh invested in companies X, Y, and Z in the ratio of 3:3:4. The beta of equity shares of X, Y, and Z are 1.2, 1.6, and 1.5 respectively. The average returns by these companies are 16%, 23%, and 18% for X, Y, and Z respectively. The risk-free rate is 6% per annum and rate of return in market is 14% per annum. You are required to compute the portfolio beta and average return on portfolio. Also use CAPM and determine the rate of return expected on such portfolio. Also determine portfolio alpha and conclude whether the portfolio is favorable or unfavorable. Would you advise any change in the portfolio? If yes, then suggest the effect of such change, assuming that the investor is required to retain at least rupees 1 lakh on each security. So friends, before we start solving the question, let us first plan the entire approach for attempting this question. Let us analyze what is given to us. The investor has placed the entire amount in hand over three stocks X, Y, and Z. So, in what proportion this money has been invested in these three stocks has been informed to you. Betas of individual stocks are also informed to you. That means we know beta of X, Y, Z, and we also know the weights of X, Y, and Z. So, through the betas and respective weights, we can find the weighted average of these individual betas to arrive at portfolio beta. Once we get portfolio beta, what we can then do is put that portfolio beta in CAPM equation. That is, to find expected return on portfolio via CAPM, what you would do? ERP, expected return on portfolio, will be RF plus RM minus RF into beta of portfolio. Once you apply that equation, you get to know what is the expected rate of return on the portfolio. The question also informs you the average past returns of the three stocks. With that and with the weights available, we can find the return on portfolio based on past performance. That will give us enough information to determine the alpha of the portfolio. Once we get alpha of the portfolio, we will be concluding whether the portfolio is performing efficient or not. And then, because the question is asking you, would you want to make any changes or recommend any changes in this existing portfolio? We would then take an individual analysis of these three stocks. We will indeed determine alpha of all the three stocks. Then we have been given a condition that you must retain 1 lakh of investment, rupees 1 lakh of investment in each of the three stocks at least. That means some stock which you may not find favorable, you will still have to keep 1 lakh rupees invested in that stock. You may move the balance amount, however, to other stocks which are appearing to be more profitable. So, we will recompose the entire portfolio. We will create a new portfolio. Once a new portfolio is constructed, there will be still three stocks, but the weights would change. If the weights have got altered, obviously, you will have to redefine the portfolio beta. You will have to recompute the portfolio beta. There will be a separate calculation of expected return on portfolio, ERP, through new CAPM equation. That is through the new beta of portfolio what you got. Even the average return on the portfolio, the RP, will also change because the weights have got changed. Thereafter, the alpha of the portfolio will again change. If this alpha of portfolio comes better than the alpha of the portfolio which you have originally calculated, that is the originally defined portfolio, whatever portfolio has been informed to you, whatever composition has been informed to you, that alpha, what we have determined earlier, will be compared with this new alpha that you have got from your suggested portfolio. And then we will see whether your recommendation is better off or whether it is making the portfolio better than earlier or not. So let us now see how to present the solution. So the solution begins with computation of portfolio beta. You know very well portfolio beta will be the weighted average of betas of individual stocks. So beta of X, Y, Z, beta of X, beta of Y, beta of Z multiplied to the respective weights of the three stocks. So we have all the information available. We compute portfolio beta as 1.44. The next thing, in the similar style, we will compute the weighted average returns of the three stocks to be assigned as the portfolio returns based on the past performance. So RP will be RX, RY, RZ, the weighted average of these three. So RX into WX plus RY into WY plus RZ into WZ. And we have again all the data available. Weights what we are applying over here obviously are same weights. So now the return on portfolio based on its past performance is 18.9%. This is the return that we are going to compare with the CAPM based return. Alright friends, let us move ahead and let us now compute the expected rate of return based on CAPM. So we are just applying CAPM equation. This requires RF plus RM minus RF into beta, beta of portfolio. This is what we have just computed in the earlier workings, and risk-free rate is given to us as 6%. Return on market portfolio is 14%. So what we get by applying this is 17.52%. So the expected rate of return based on CAPM is obtained, and we have already obtained the average past returns on the portfolio. And finally, we are ready to compute portfolio alpha. So alpha of portfolio will be RP minus ERP, and what we get is 18.9 minus 17.52, that is 1.38% positive. And what we conclude, portfolio is favorable because alpha is positive. Let us move ahead. Because the question has asked you whether you would recommend any change in the existing portfolio, let us analyze each stock included in the portfolio individually in terms of their efficiency or performance. And for that, what we do is, we would say calculation of expected rate of return using CAPM as well as alpha for three individual securities. So for security X, let us first compute the expected rate of return as per CAPM. Friends, observe one thing, this time we are not calculating the expected return on portfolio. This is the expected return on the individual security, that is X. And therefore, the beta that we have considered over here in CAPM equation is beta of stock X. And what we are getting through CAPM, it is 15.6% as expected rate of return. And alpha of X will be RX minus ERX. What is given to us in the question, the past returns of stock X on an average is 16%. So 16 minus 15.6, you are getting positive alpha for security X. That means security X in itself, standalone basis, is a favorable security. What you have made as calculation of alpha for security X, similar calculations will be needed for security Y and Z also. So let us do that. So for security Y, ERY will be RF plus RM minus RF into beta of Y. What we are getting as 18.8%, and alpha for security Y is again obtained as RY minus ERY, and that is resulting into 4.2% positive. Similarly, for security Z, when you calculate the expected rate of return as per CAPM, it is 18%. And when you calculate alpha, alpha for this security is 0. 0 because its past average return is also 18%, and what is expected as per CAPM is also 18%. Now if you observe, the substantially positive alpha is found in security Y. That means security Y is giving highly favorable result. Security Z's alpha is 0. That means there is no problem in retaining security Z. There is no problem in retaining security X also. But X and Z are giving either no surplus returns or little more than what is being expected. So it will be wise to put more money on security Y. Because of the limitation given in the question, we will have to maintain 1 lakh of investment in X and Z, and the balance amount of investment can be diverted to Y. So let us first write down that part. So what we say is, it is observed that investing in security Y will be most favorable. Therefore, the investor should retain rupees 1 lakh for each securities X and Z as minimum requirement, and balance 3 lakh should be invested in Y. Obviously, with this recommendation, your portfolio allocation, that means the allocation of investment in each of the three stocks would change. In simple words, the weights of the three stocks will change. So, calculation of revised beta and alpha for the recommended portfolio. So, new portfolio beta will be weighted average of the betas of the three stocks. So, it will be same thing conceptually, but the calculation will differ because the weights have changed. So, 1 lakh invested in stock X, 3 lakh invested in stock Y, and 1 lakh invested in stock Z. So, we have 1:3:1 ratio. So, the weights become 1/5, 3/5 and 1/5 respectively for X, Y and Z. And beta of portfolio, which is revised, it is coming to 1.5 times. Alright friends, let us move ahead. Once we have computed the revised portfolio beta, we would now compute the revised portfolio returns as well as revised alpha. So, revised RP, same procedure of calculation, only difference is the weights have got changed. So, RP will also change. Conceptually, RP remains the weighted average of returns of individual stock. And this time you may see, this has increased to 20.6%. Revised return as per CAPM will also change because the beta has changed. This time, the CAPM based expected rate of return has got revised to 18%. And finally, we compute revised alpha, that is RP minus ERP. Again, conceptually same, but the calculations will differ because of changes in the weights. And this time, it is 2.6%. Earlier, it was around 1.38%. So, what we conclude, by making the recommended changes, the portfolio is certainly better off.